Hi y'all, Liz here again today, and still talking about the ABCs of cleaning, the basics. And today I want to talk about cleaning for health, because really, bottom line is, that's what we're doing. We're trying to clean to make people's environment more healthy. Sure, there's other stuff that we're doing as well, make it look good, to make it be like a feeling of relief for people, but bottom line is we're trying to make it more healthy. The people would never have started cleaning in the very old days in the beginning except for the health aspect, right? Trying to make it healthy for everybody. So the reason why I want to talk about cleaning for health is when you're cleaning, you need to keep in mind that that's what you're doing. If you're not remembering that piece, there are certain things that can get missed. Let's say you are working for Natural Care Cleaning Services. My friend Diana's business down there in Texas, and they use a lot of ladybugs, right? They use vapor steam, which is does an excellent job of eliminating dangerous things from surfaces. But what if you're not thinking about cleaning for health? How easy would it be to just skip over stuff and just go really, really quickly? You could. You can't do that. There's a whole reason why you guys are using this amazing equipment, because it does a very, very effective job at what it does. It eliminates harmful viruses, bacteria, etc. from surfaces, but only if you use it correctly. So you have to be thinking about, we're cleaning for health, not just trying to go through the motions. Same thing if you maybe work for my company. If you work for my company though, and you are cleaning and you know you've been trained to clean counters using this one method, if you're not remembering about cleaning for health, how easy would it be to apply something to a counter and then leave it there? No, you can't. You can't leave stuff on a counter, because the little kids are gonna come along and they're gonna put their sandwich on a counter, right? And then they're gonna pick it up, and what's on the bottom of that sandwich? Chemicals that they're gonna then put in their mouth. Or you're gonna be using some type of a harsh chemical potentially on a flooring, right? And leaving it on the floor. Some things you can put on a floor and you don't have to rinse them, because they will evaporate up and they will eliminate themselves from the surface as they dry. Awesome. But are you sure that that's what you're using? You need to be sure, because you need to keep in mind that you're cleaning for the health of the residents in the houses that you're cleaning for. Also for yourself, right? Which we're going to talk about next week when we talk about safety. But cleaning for health means keeping the area that you're cleaning healthy, creating a healthy environment, making it a healthy place to live and be for the residents. Another quick one is that I wanted to point out, vacuuming. When you're vacuuming, you gotta be paying attention. Make sure that your vacuum bags don't have any holes, that you don't have leaks if you have canisters, etc. Because otherwise you're pushing all of that stuff, all of those pollutants off into the air. How healthy is that for the people that are coming in to breathe this air that is now full of all of these allergens, pollutants, etc.? Not too much. So again, remembering that you're cleaning for the health of the environment and the people that live in this environment, it's going to take you a long way toward a better cleaning job. You're going to be doing a better service for the people you clean for. Okay, that's it for today. And oh, my question is, what's one area that you never really thought about in terms of cleaning for health? You just sort of thought you were just sort of picking up or tidying. It didn't really occur to you that you were making anything healthier. For me, my initial thing was the bedrooms. I never really thought of it that way. But if you think about all of the stuff that goes on in bedrooms, you know, just tons of stuff that goes on in bedrooms, you can realize, wow, yeah, there's stuff that needs to be removed off those surfaces. It needs to be cleaned, obviously, to make a healthier environment. So how about you? What's the thing that you never really thought about before and you now find yourself focusing better on? All right, talk to you tomorrow. Bye.